Samanya kuno kumbira masanchis. Gashende monga shende. The African Development Bank recognizes that poor infrastructure is a critical barrier to accelerating growth and poverty reduction in Africa. Infrastructure is considered a key component of the investment climate by reducing the cost of doing business and enabling people to access markets. It is a precondition for private sector development and a key enabler of integration of regional, sub-regional markets for intra-African trade and positioning of a competitive Africa in world markets. Investments in infrastructure are thus critical to advances in agriculture and fundamental to human development, including the delivery of health and education services to poor people. Infrastructure is an enormous untapped potential for the creation of productive employment. For Zimbabwe, the imposition of economic sanctions has subsequently led to the drying up of traditional sources of external finance from the international financial institutions such as African Development Bank, the International Monetary Fund, and the World Bank. These international financial institutions stopped their support to Zimbabwe by instituting a number of suspensions on balance of payment support, technical assistance, voting, and related rights by the IMF, and failure to access fund resources. For the infrastructure sector, this has resulted in doom and gloom, thereby resulting in infrastructure deficit.
For the past 20 years, government, including private sector, and the stakeholders who have been involved directly or indirectly in infrastructure development, they have been barred from accessing credit lines and the facilities that back such. So to that end, it then means that 20 years ago we had a notion and a move that gradually collapsed the issue of infrastructural development.
The country's external debt situation, which has been worsened by the sanctions curse, remains one of the major impediments to attract foreign lines of credit due to high sovereign risk. The effects of sanctions has thus created an unstable macroeconomic environment, characterized by foreign currency shortages and low investor confidence. This has negatively impacted on the efforts to mobilize long-term capital suitable for infrastructure investments. Economic growth and development cannot be achieved without the availability of appropriate economic and social infrastructure. The deterioration in Zimbabwe's basic infrastructure in the past two decades has in turn resulted in a serious impact on the productive sectors of the economy and on the level of quality of services to the public.
What we are supposed to be accessing across all sectors, name it health, name it education, name it agriculture, we are failing to access what we are supposed to be accessing, what we are supposed to be getting as a nation and as a people. Illegal sanctions against Zimbabwe are a direct, not even indirect, are a direct human rights violation.
According to the Infrastructure Development Bank of Zimbabwe 2019 annual report, infrastructure deficiencies, particularly electricity, water and transport, continue to put a drag on the country's social and economic transformation. As Zimbabwe is still battling with the sanctions, it is time to reflect on the negative effects of sanctions on this sector. This spelt doom for infrastructure development in Zimbabwe. There has been a lack of investment in infrastructure projects. The condition of roads has deteriorated to the point that Zimbabwe has become a bottleneck on the north-south transport corridor. It is important to note that Zimbabwe is on the crossroads of Africa, occupying a strategic position on the north-south corridor. It has strong road connections with SADC.
Our target is 2023. It must finish, and that's the road that is key. It's a national road, economic road, and it joins, links north-south corridor. So it's very, very important. And government is putting much importance to it by way of funding it. It's being funded, and I'm happy about that because His Excellency has made sure that funding is available.
Through the North-South Corridor, Zimbabwe is linked to its neighbors, South Africa, Mozambique, Botswana, Zambia, the Democratic Republic of Congo, Malawi, and Tanzania. It also serves as a link to other important corridors that branch off from it, such as the Trans-Kalahari, Beira, and Dar es Salaam. Despite the sanctions albatross, the Zimbabwean government is still in the process of re-engaging with international organizations for it to be able to access international finance. While the government, in conjunction with SADC, is still lobbying for the immediate removal of economic sanctions, the Second Republic administration, under the leadership of President Emmerson Mnangagwa, has pioneered resilient measures to boost the country's resistance to economic sanctions.
We shall continue to denounce these sanctions, but above that, that does not deter us to pursue progressive developmental programs in our country in a peaceful, democratic and observing the rule of law in our country.
The administration is showing that it is determined to circumvent the illegal sanctions and develop the country using locally mobilized resources.
Government has provided funding to complete all roads that were at an advanced stage. What's happening here is that it's a dualization which has been done by our own Department of Roads. As you can see, they've done a good job. This shows that internally the government has its own manpower and technical know-how. As compared to the private as well, we have what we have in Bedbridge Road, where the private, local private people are doing the work. And the same quality is coming up. That shows Zimbabwe, whether it's public or private, you meet people who are well-qualified and people who can deliver.
The Zimbabwean government has not been deterred to transform the lives of people. Through ring fencing resources, various infrastructure projects in the sectors of health, education, water, power, and roads are at advanced execution stages to allow delivery in the short term.
This country is resilient, and we have got solidarity support, and we are making progress despite the sanctions which are there. And therefore, I would like to say, even to the people of Zimbabwe, we must be congratulated for the resilience which we have resembled for the past 20 years under these difficult circumstances. But the issue is that we have got the support, but let us then move forward and make progress as the green shoots are starting to come out and capitalize and achieve the Vision 2030 for the purposes of getting ourselves. By the time we go over the river, when we have done things on our own, we will be untouchable.